Hallelujah. While they're receiving, Justin, will you come on up here for a moment? And I tell you, this was a we were at LA Fitness last night and casting devils out of somebody in LA Fitness. Come on, seriously, right? I mean, we're not talking, I mean, real deal, full-blown deliverance. Talked to the guy today. He says, man, everything's different. I got such peace and I feel clean and I feel free. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. So Justin was sharing with me a testimony happened on Friday with his little brother. And this is so cool. I want you guys, why don't you share what was going on? What happened?
All right, guys. So Friday night, we go out and evangelize every week. And my brother came in town from Georgia. His name is Paul. He's
now, Justin is
old.
Justin is one. This guy got saved, what, about 5 months ago?
Yes.
About 5 months ago. He came to church on a Tuesday night. Was it Saturday night?
Saturday
night.
Yes.
Came to church on a Saturday night. I just focused on him. And so I took him out to eat. Come on, y'all hearing me? No, listen. I'm giving you an example. Come on, amen? So, I had one agenda. Get him saved. Sat there, ministered to him quite some time, and gave the word of God to him. He right there got born again, and he has been radical for God.
Hallelujah.
Ever since. So now you got your. So he's out there soul winning. This guy is a soul winning machine. Him and Bourne, oh my goodness, the dynamic duo. They are crazy, but go ahead.
Hallelujah. So we go out, and I invite my brother to go evangelizing.
Yeah.
And he's 17 years old once again. So we go out to South Lake Town Square, and we were going to see a movie afterwards. So I tell him, or as I'm getting out of the car to check movie times, he's like, we have a problem. And I'm like, what's up, man? And he says, I'm not saved. Well, I just kind of assumed he was. so that's what you get for assuming. But so we end up parking, and I go, and everyone's kind of walking, and I just grab Bourne and kind of pull him back a little bit. And then I have my brother stand with us, and I'm like, hey, man, we got a dilemma. And I tell him what's going on. So we end up covering all the bases, A through Z, telling him about God, how, you know, what happened in the Garden of Eden from the fall to the crucifixion, everything. Well, he's just standing there in tears. The Holy Spirit just comes down, touches him. Then after that, he prays a salvation prayer, right? So then me and Bourne are standing there for probably about 10 minutes, you know, just baptizing him in the Holy Spirit, just, you know, speaking tongues on him and everything. And then out of nowhere, he just starts speaking tongues. So it was awesome. Hallelujah. So then we give him a crash course on soul saving. And
okay, all right. He just got saved, baptized the Holy Ghost. Now he's out soul winning.
So... Hallelujah.
Some of y'all been saved 30 years, ain't done that yet. I didn't say that.
So we're walking up and we see these two guys come up and we just kind of threw them to the wolves and we're like, go get him, man. And didn't even show him an example. So he was a trooper. He walks up to him and started to proceed with the script. Well, they were kind of tough for a first time. So I ended up stepping in and Bourne grabs him and takes him away. Well, he leads him up to this group about six, and right when he starts mentioning anything about Jesus and God, five of the six just walk away. Well, he leads that one person to the Lord, right? Prays the salvation prayer within 30 minutes of being saved. And then about 20 minutes after that, he goes and leads two other people to the Lord. So it was awesome. God was moving. Hallelujah.
Amen. Come on, somebody give God praise. Yes, you got me there. What? I love it. They took him out soul winning. He wasn't even saved. Oh, we got to fix that. Get him saved. Baptize the Holy Ghost. And he leads three people to Jesus. That is just incredible. If our guys in the back could make sure that everybody's in from the team, I really want everybody focused on what God has for us here. Oh, my Father God, thank you, Jesus. Somebody said the devil's a liar. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I need someone to do me a favor. Benjamin, come here quickly. Hallelujah. I need you to run to signal area and get my notes up. All those scriptures you put in are wrong. But I know exactly where I'm starting. Because I'm starting by the Holy Spirit. As a matter of fact, I think you have some papers for me. You can hand them to me, a copy. I want you to open your Bibles to the book of Amos, chapter 3. Amos, chapter 3. Tonight, we're beginning on a very powerful series in the Holy Spirit, where we're going to go very deep. Someone say very deep.
Very deep.
We're going to go very deep by revelation. Now, you will notice I use that word revelation a lot. Because there is a great difference between knowledge, information, and divine revelation. Knowledge has limited power, but revelation has unlimited power. I don't know about you, but I don't want just knowledge. I want unlimited power. We're going to begin to go down this path, this series on this spiritual warfare school of ministry, which is exactly what it is. We're going to be here for several months. We're not going to be in a rush in this. We're developing a course, a Bible training course that we're going to make available online. We're going to put together in DVD packages. We're going to have notes. We're going to have study guides to bring the body of Christ back into a revelation and a deeper dimension of revelation on spiritual warfare than they've ever gone before. Because the body of Christ, the Lord spoke to me a few years ago, and he said, my body has treated spiritual warfare as a fad that has now passed. I don't know about you, but how many know the devil is not a fad? Huh? And warfare hasn't passed. But you've got people out there now that are preaching, that's not our battle. They're preaching, we don't have to deal with that. They got a little element of a truth, which we're going to talk about, that the enemy is defeated. And they say it's not the battle. So they never deal with it. And as a result, people are bound up. Yeah. That young man last night, who we led to the Lord. I don't know, Lord. Who we led to the Lord a couple weeks ago, but still was bound up by some demons, needed something dealt with. Yeah. Yeah. We're going to open and unveil the strategies of Satan, the strategies of Jesus in dealing with Satan, huh? How to locate our enemy. God is going to bring to us understanding of the authority that we really have, how the enemy operates, what's really going on in the atmosphere. We're going to see, everybody say, by divine revelation. Can you guys give me just a smidgen more? But if we're going to go there, we're going to have to start with a series of breakthroughs tonight. I'm going to speak to you under a very strong apostolic and prophetic anointing. I don't say that lightly. Please put it deep in your spirit. Do not look at me as your typical preacher. Thank God for many good preachers out there. I've never been interested in being a good preacher. Please, we've got to understand what we're really dealing with here. And I don't say that to draw attention to myself. All you have to do is spend time with me. You know I don't think, I mean, you spend time with me, I don't think a whole lot of myself. Look at the clothes I wear. Give me a break. I don't think a whole lot of myself. But I think a whole lot of the call and the gift of God. And I've learned to recognize that if we don't understand and recognize the gifts that are in our midst, we will miss much of what God has for us. Huh? Come on. Because, oh, we're going to hit this so strong tonight. Because we look so often at the natural. And we can't see into the spirit. I want to lay a foundation here tonight by revelation. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. Familiar portion of scripture to us. Let it go deep in your spirit. It says this. Surely the Lord God does nothing. Someone say nothing. Unless he reveals his secrets to his servants, the prophets. Someone say God does nothing. Say it again. Say God does nothing. Except he reveals his secrets to his servants, the prophets. Now, although there is a difference in the role of the Old Testament prophet to the New Testament prophet, and although we operate as a church, as a prophetic generation, come on, amen. Back then, God wasn't speaking to everyone individually. Today, we can all hear his voice. Come on, amen. But that does not mean that God doesn't reveal specific things and anoint the prophets with specific revelations to bring forth into the body of Christ. We have become so in the belief system that God can speak to me, and he does. And that I can hear the voice of God, and I pray you do. That sometimes we then write off the role of the prophets, but God spoke to me. I was in New Zealand. I had gone down there ministering March of 1999. I had just had an experience back at my church. We were launching a new church, and we had a Bible study. My head evangelist came in extra late with a couple young men. As soon as he walked in the door, the Spirit of God was grieved. I couldn't understand why. I asked the Lord later. He said he was in an extreme act of disobedience. I said, Lord, what was it? So I called him up. I said, what did you do before you came to church? He said, oh, I went and saw a movie. It was called The Matrix. The Holy Spirit spoke to this prophet. When I saw the first commercial, the Holy Spirit spoke to me. And he said, you warn my people, don't watch that movie. He said, there's a demon spirit that is a forerunner to the Antichrist that's on that movie that will cause people to question reality. And then he said, March, this is the first one. They didn't even know if it'd be a flop. God said, there'll be three of them. Boy, are y'all looking at me? Huh? Nobody knew. There was hardly any movies that did trilogies. You had Back to the Future and a couple. But that wasn't a common thing. That wasn't like today, once you get a movie, you know you got at least three. That wasn't a common thing. That was very, very rare. I think Back to the Future was one of the only ones, a couple others. But that was it. You didn't see trilogies. But the Lord, the Holy Spirit spoke to me. He said, you warn my people. Now, I know a lot of Christians would say, oh, but Brother Steve, it had so many spiritual, hidden messages. Yeah, they were hidden spiritual messages from the enemy. Try to write it where it looked kind of like it was kind of like a savior. Yeah, it was a false. I don't want to go down that path. So I'm down in New Zealand telling this story afterwards, and I get on the plane, and a lady who is in one of the meetings is sitting right next to me, right behind me. So we start talking about it. And she said, oh, but I went to that movie. Oh, it was so good. God talked to me so much through it. And I said, Lord, did I miss it? Come on, anybody ever been there? Yeah. I mean, you know you heard from God, but nobody else seems to see what you see. I said, did I miss it? And the Lord spoke to me. He said, son, I have given my prophets eyes to see things that others will not see. And my body has failed to understand the role of my prophets. Huh? They're fine as long as you come and prophesy some blessing. But you tell them, oh, Jesus. You warn them about some things that are coming. You tell them, and he said specifically to me, he said, my people have failed to understand the role of my prophets when it comes to these things like movies and music and stuff. I gave them eyes to see stuff that they haven't. But here's the arrogance of the church today. We sit back and we say, oh, no, but I didn't see it. I didn't get convicted by it. That's because you weren't given eyes from God to see it, but you were given ears to hear the voice of the prophet. Ooh, I don't like that. No, especially here in Texas. Come on, we got that fierce independence. Well, if God don't speak to me, he did through his servant. Now, you say, oh, Brother Steve, whoo, what if someone takes that to an abuse? Anything with power can be abused. Come on, amen? Anything of power can be abused. But you don't throw it all out because a few carnal people try to use a principle to manipulate for their own selfish purposes. Somebody say, God will do nothing except he reveals his secrets to his servants, the prophets. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20. See, I already probably lost 20% of the people that are listening to these DVDs. Probably they're already trying to turn me off. I don't agree with that. I know, you don't see. Come on, we got to stop apologizing for who we are. And we got to not be intimidated to stand up boldly. Huh? Come on. When Peter came out of that upper room, when he went down to the gate, beautiful, he didn't go up to that little crippled man and say, well, you know, I'm going to believe God for a miracle here. He said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have. I know that I got something. And brother, if you'll receive it, you'll get what I got. Yeah. Woo! Yeah. Hallelujah. Woo. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, it's time you begin to walk in the confidence of what God has given you. Yeah. Woo! Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody say the devil's a liar. We're going to say that a lot here. Say it again. Devil, you're a liar. Now, 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20. We know the story of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir have come on to the... Just keep it on. I'll tell you when to start. Hallelujah. Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir have gone up against the armies of Israel. Jehoshaphat called for a fast. Thank God. God, back then, people didn't walk around like a bunch of Americans. Well, I just don't feel led to fast. Back then, if you didn't fast, they killed you. And when they called a fast, even the cows fasted. Huh? Come on, somebody. Come on, amen. That's not just back then. That's in most of the world today. Come on, you go over to Korea. Where they've in South Korea, Seoul, Korea, 6 of the 20th largest churches in the world. The pastor stands up and says, we fast. Even the children fast. Everybody fast. Why? Come on. Listen, I'm just telling you the way it is. Hello. Oh, Lord. I'm in so much trouble right now. Huh? Now, listen, I'm not talking about going to some crazy level of authority. I don't want you coming to me asking me what color car you're supposed to buy. I could care less. Get pink polka dots for all I care. Don't waste my time. I don't want to micromanage the little nitty-gritties of your life. Come on, amen? How can we have an army if everybody's doing their own thing? Well, I wasn't going to go down that path. Good. I got to hit that for a moment. Can I smack that devil for a moment? Woo! You say, why? Because we're going to lead you into the front lines of spiritual warfare. And I don't want to lead a disbanded, disruptive, chaotic, undisciplined army to face down the forces of darkness, because that's the enemy. Will slaughter you. But if we are unified in the spirit, the devil hasn't got a chance. Somebody say in the spirit.
In the spirit.
Say it again. In the spirit.
In the spirit.
Can I give you karamashande? Whew, come, say it again. In the spirit.
In the spirit.
You know the number one sign that you're in the spirit? You're unified. Oh, you didn't hear what I just said. Number one sign that you're in the spirit and I'm in the spirit and you're in the spirit, we're unified. Because the Holy Spirit doesn't fight against himself. Huh? And when the Holy Spirit, when you're in the Spirit and I'm in the Spirit and you're in the Spirit, I will be walking in humility and love and preferring my brother above myself. So maybe the anointing's on me and then it shifts over to you and I'll just step out of the way and let it happen there. And then it shifts over to her and we get out of the way and nobody's trying to posture for position. Because we're all focused on one thing. What is God saying at this moment? And what is he doing? Somebody say in the spirit. We see in the book of Ruth. Oh my goodness. Book of Ruth. I got to give you this quickly. It's just too powerful. Huh? It said chapter 1 verse 1. Look at this real quick. Hallelujah. Now I hope you don't expect a 35-minute class. Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land. And a certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, everybody say the house of bread and praise. That's what Bethlehem, Judah means. Went to dwell or sojourn or go off course in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons. Now, I could preach for hours on this. Just look at this way. There was a day, in the days when the judges ruled, there was a famine in the land. So what was happening in the days when the judges ruled? Well, go back one verse to the very last verse of the book of Judges. 21:25 says this. In those days, what days? What's the book of Judges? So the days when the judges ruled. In those days, there was no king in Israel. Everyone did what was right in their own eyes. When there's no clear authority in the kingdom of God, everybody does what's right in their own eyes. And what is the fruit of that? In the days when the judges ruled, when there was no king in Israel and everybody did what was right in their own eyes, it produced famine. My God, my God, my God. Someone say the devil's a liar. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20. Called for a fast. Prayed. God spoke to him. The battle's not yours, but mine. We'll come back to that in a few weeks. Verse 20, listen to this. So they rose early in the morning and went out into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me. O Jerusalem and you inhabitants of Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God. You shall be established. Believe his. Believe his. Believe his. Believe his prophets and you shall
prosper.
1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 18. You say, why are you spending all this time? I thought we're going to spiritual warfare. Why are you spending all this time about the prophet? Because I got some prophecies to give you. Hallelujah. How many want to hear the word of the Lord tonight? Ooh, you're going to like it too. It's good. 2 o'clock in the morning, God spoke to me. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 18. And part of 19, this charge I commit to you. This is my command to you, son Timothy. According to the prophecies previously made concerning you. That by them, by what? By the prophecies we gave you, you may wage the good warfare. Woo! Oh, you didn't get that. Come on. Come on. But by that word of prophecy, you now can go and declare war. Say it after me. I'm going to declare war on the devil's war. Say it again. I'm going to declare war on the devil's war. Woo. That you may wage the good warfare having faith. How'd you get faith? Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And in this context, faith came by hearing, and came hearing by the word of prophecy. Somebody say, Timothy, trusted the word of prophecy, and he prospered. Can I give you a word tonight? He'll open your spirit. Thus saith the Lord. This is what God spoke to me to speak over you. I've given it to you in writing. I want you to grab it. Put it up on your refrigerator. Put it in your bedroom. Put it on your mirror. Get it in your spirit. God said, I will establish my people with wondrous weapons of warfare that will confound the enemy and cause my glory to break forth on the earth. You shall see my power, my authority, and my mighty right hand shatter previously impenetrable arenas. You shall see my mighty angels warring to bring about my purposes. You shall see the enemy flee from before you. And you shall see wondrous manifestations of my delivering power. For you shall not be defeated by the enemy. No, you didn't hear that. You would have, somebody would have jumped and shouted and did a little dance in the Holy Ghost. Let me say that again. Just give me a hair more. For you shall not be defeated by the enemy. Somebody say, I'm not going to be defeated. Say it again, I'm not going to be defeated. You get done with this spiritual warfare school of ministry. You get a hold of this divine revelation. I tell you in the name of Jesus, you're never going to be defeated again. Come on, that's got to be more than, well, may it just preacher talk. Trust in the Lord your God, so shall you be established. Trust his prophets, so shall you prosper. Surely the Lord God does nothing except he first reveals his secrets to his servants, the prophets. Take on this word of prophecy which was spoken over you, that you may wage the good warfare. Somebody say, this is God's word for me. Say it again. This is God's word for me. Woo. For you shall not be defeated by the enemy, nor shall you be afraid of him. For you will know that it is I who am fighting the battle. You will see yourself as I have made you. And you shall see the enemy as he really is. I will place my anointing upon you, and you shall be as David before me. I can already tell I'm going to have to read this prophecy over and over again over the next few weeks, because it's going to break loose inside of your spirit. You shall not flinch, and you shall not fail. Somebody say, I'm not going to be intimidated anymore. Say it again, say, I'm not going to be intimidated anymore. Huh? You know why so many people don't want to press into these realms? Because they're intimidated. Oh, Brother Steve, better be careful. Don't go too much out there in spiritual warfare. Because the devil's going to come after your body. He's going to come after your finances. He's going to come after your family. You just got to be careful. You're intimidated. The devil's already winning with you before you even get out into the battle. He's already got you in a position where you can't win. Why? What he's got you, oh Lord Jesus, Shahande, he's got you in a defensive position. Nobody can win a battle from a defensive position. Somebody pray in the Holy Ghost for a moment. Come on, pray in the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth and speak. Huh? That's the devil want to keep your mouth shut. Just sit back there. Well, just sit here. No, open your mouth and speak. You're uttering mysteries with your spirit. Oh, my God, there it is, yes. Yes, yes. Shakara mama mande. Shiri andere ba 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 ka kande. Shandere ba 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 shandere ke ke ba sha cha cha ande. Shiri andere ba kande. Jesus. Somebody say the devil's a liar. I wasn't going to do this part tonight, but we got to get a breakthrough right now. How are you ready for a spiritual breakthrough right here? Jesus, this is heaven, never came to teach you how to defend yourself. I'm going to say that again. Jesus, now, if we're going to go into this level of spiritual warfare, revelation, we're going to have to open our spirits and understand. Jesus never came to teach you how to defend yourself, because Jesus never put you into a losing position, which is a position of defense. He said, my glory's your rear guard. Don't worry about your backside. He said, I'll give my angels charge over you, lest you dash your foot upon the stone. He said, don't worry about your front side. He said, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. He said, the battle's not yours, but mine, says the Lord. He never came to teach you how to defend yourself. It was never his intention that the church of Jesus Christ be sitting in a defensive posture trying to keep the devil at bay. Come on. This is one of the greatest lies of the enemy. He said to Peter, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. But what do we have in our minds? We think these big giant gates marching up against us. Ooh, here comes the gates, and they're not going to conquer me. That's not what he was talking about. Gates don't march. Gates don't move. Gates are keeping you out from something you want to get into. He's saying, I'm going to build my church, and whatever you go against, whatever you launch an offensive against of the enemy, those strongholds will come down. Huh? Huh? can't win a battle from a defensive position. Say it, I cannot win. From an offense, defensive position. I must do it from offense. Jesus didn't come. From the beginning of time. Oh, my Lord Jesus. I'm going to break this open more next week. You're going to get, it's going to change inside of you. If I spend 3 weeks just on this, it'll revolutionize your entire Christian experience. Come on. Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. Very first thing God spoke to him. Spoke to man. The Bible says, and then God blessed them and said, be fruitful, multiply, fill the earth, subdue. Somebody say offensive. Say it again, say offensive. Subdue. Have dominion. The very first thing God spoke to man, and the very first thing God said, when I put my blessing upon you, I'm calling you to launch an offensive, to take authority and control in this earth. And God has never changed his plan and his purpose for his people. Oh, my Lord, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Someone say the devil's a liar. Say it again, say the devil's a liar. Say it again, the devil's a liar. Shakarama shande, haramo shande. Now, don't put that up, please. Don't put that up, please. Keep that off the screen. Someone said the devil's a liar. I'm going to break. By revelation, deeper next week. Everybody say, God does not want me to be in a defensive position, but to be on offense. It's going to shift you. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Sorry, chapter 10, verse 3 and 4 from the King James Version. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. But mighty through God. To the pulling down of strongholds. Somebody say, our weapons are supernatural. They're mighty through God. That Greek word literally means mighty to God. That is, mighty before God. I'm reading you the definition. Not humanly, but divinely powerful. The power is not ours, but God's. I want to give you three specific prophecies and promises of God right now. Number one, in this spiritual warfare school of ministry, the Lord will strengthen you to stand in the face of any enemy. Thank you for the two patty cakes. That... Say it after me. The Lord will strengthen me to stand in the face of any enemy. There's no devil too strong. Come on. There's no stronghold too strong. Why? Because God is going to give you supernatural natural, divinely powerful weapons. He never intended for you to do this in your own strength. He never intended for you to do this in your own power. He never intended you to do it in the natural. Woo! Somebody say in the spirit. Say it again, say in the spirit. Shh. Number two, God is going to take you into a new level of spiritual warfare prayer. I almost feel sorry for the devil. Come on, I don't feel sorry for him. He deserves everything he's going to get. But I almost feel sorry for him, because when God gets through with you in this spiritual warfare school of ministry and you move from the defensive position where 95% of you live your life, huh? Just trying to get through, just trying to ward off another attack, just trying to wait until, oh, I just hope it just, oh man, the devil's been chasing me. Oh, he's been chasing me. There is not one day the devil should be chasing you. Come on, I'm not trying to be critical, please. I'm not trying to belittle. I'm not trying to make you feel small. We're that way because that's the way we've been trained. That's the way we've even heard it from the pulpit. Oh, I just barely made it through that. Oh, God never, what an indictment on the glory of God and the authority of God and the word of God when the creator of the universe has said, behold, I give unto thee power over all the power of the enemy, and he shall by no means harm you. Huh? We're running around intimidated. Somebody say intimidation. Say it again, say intimidation. One of the great strategies of the enemy. Fear. Why? Because if he can get you to be intimidated, he can shut down your anointing. Huh? Nothing will rob you of your anointing. Nothing will rob you of operating in faith than intimidation. Shh. Some say, I'm not going to be intimidated anymore. Woo! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Come on, we're putting up a new billboard. We had a new one going up this week. We told them to stop it. We were going to put up Hungry for More of God. That's a great billboard. We told them to stop it. We're putting up a billboard. Spiritual Warfare School of Ministry. We're inviting the whole neighborhood out. We're inviting the whole church out. Why don't you get in this atmosphere and learn how to take the battle to the doorstep of the enemy and defeat that slew-footed devil once and for all. Huh? Oh, Brother Steve, aren't you afraid the witches will show up? Let them show up. We'll cast that devil out of them. Oh, what if they start putting curses and hexes? Let them try. Let them try. He gives his angels charge over us. It's time we stop being intimidated by the devil. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. What are you afraid of? What are you afraid of? Oh, karamashakande, karamashande, rabashande. Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, somebody say that name. Jesus. Come on, somebody say that name. Jesus. Come on, say that name. Karamoshakaramashande. God is going to take you into a new level of spiritual warfare prayer. It's not going to be natural. It's not going to be a bunch of human effort. It's going to be with divine supernatural weapons, with divine power and divine authority. The devil hasn't got a chance. Woo! Shakara Mashande. Shakara Mashande. Come on, let it bubble out of your spirit. It's all right. It's all right. Don't hold that back. When that starts happening, let it happen. Let it happen. That's where revelation breaks loose, Shahande. Shiriandaramo Shakara Mashande. Shandiribi Karamo Shandiribi Shende. Kandiribi Kodonde. Jesus. Third prophecy. You will see more answers to prayer than at any time in your life. Ooh, come on, are you getting that in your spirit? Come on, are you grabbing a hold of that by faith? Are you going to take those prophecies and wage a good war? Ephesians chapter 6. Glory to God. Shakara Mashande. Come on, the devil's a liar. Come on, we're moving out of a defensive position into an offensive position. We're going to stop being intimidated. We're going to stop hesitating. Well, I don't know if I'm ready. I don't know if I'm ready, buddy. I'm just not sure I'm there. My God, do you know who's on the inside of you? You're ready. If you don't back down. Come on. If you don't back down, you can't fail. Just put that in your spirit. I'm going to have to spend an hour on that one at some point. Ephesians 6:12. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood. Somebody say, my battle is not in the natural, but against principalities. Against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. Now, quickly, if we're going to enter into this new level of spiritual warfare prayer, we're going to have to break through one of the greatest hindrances to our spiritual growth. We're going to have to break through our environment. Every one of us is a product of our environment. We're a product of our upbringing, our cultures, our previous church experiences. Come on, amen. Our doctrines. We're products of our environment. And when God tries to bring us into a new experience, somebody say experience. We have a confrontation with our environment. Try to get somebody to pray with some force. Kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. But their environment has told them in church you're quiet. I deal with this all over the world. Try to get them to take it by force. They're like, come on, pray strong. Pray strong. You think that's forceful?
No.
Then they say, well, I just don't think that's necessary. I didn't tell you whether you thought. I wasn't asking you to think. I was asking you to obey. I just don't think. I don't care. I don't care about your opinion. I don't care about my opinion. I only care about what God's word says, and I only care about what works. Now, if you can get forceful being quiet, help. You know, help yourself. Be my guest. If you can get for, Jim, my experience, most people can. Huh? My Lord. Come on. We got to break through our environment. Well, I just don't get saved. It's not necessary if I'm going to really worship God. I don't think it's necessary to dance. Although the Bible says, praise the Lord with the dance. I just don't think that's necessary. You're a product of your environment. Huh? If you were raised in church where they dance all the time, come on, you get to do a good black gospel church, man. I mean, the babies are calling dance. Oh, come on, Jesus. Come on, right? Right, well, no, but you were raised in some stiff white church. Somebody help me out here a little bit. Oh, no, we're all proper. No, you're just stiff. Huh? You go over to Africa, they worship for 2 hours. Why, that's what they're doing to do. They dance around the building. They get all sweaty. Hallelujah. They're in church all day long. It's 110 degrees. You know what I'm talking about, Frank. It's down in Nicaragua, 110 degrees. It's sweaty. It's like a jungle down there. And they're like, what do you mean a 45-minute service? We only got through the first song in 45 minutes. Huh? We're a product of our environment. There's people other ways. Oh, my Lord God. There's some people who, you know, they can't respond. They can't even get anointed until it's gone on for 2 hours, because that's what they would do. They would go through all these things for 2 hours, and then the Holy Ghost would fall. So they've already predetermined that's the way it is. And so until we're there for 2 hours, the Holy Ghost can't fall. So then I walk into a meeting and immediately stand up, and bam, the power of God starts falling. And they're like resistant, like, oh, that's not, this is not the time yet. Come on, amen. Come on. If we're going to move into a new dimension of spiritual warfare prayer, we're going to have to get a breakthrough of our environment. We're going to have to come to this thing with a humility. We're going to have to come like little children. The greatest enemy to revelation is presumption. I'm going to say that again. That's going to drop in your spirit in a moment here. The greatest enemy to revelation is presumption. What do you mean? I already know that, Brother Steve. I'm waiting for you to give me something new. Why? You haven't walked, you're not operating what we told you before. Huh? Come on. I already heard this thing about spiritual warfare. I know all those scriptures. No, you have knowledge of those scriptures, but you don't have revelation. Because if you had revelation, there would be power manifested as a result of the revelation that you had. And we're not talking about the one time you saw a deliverance. And I'm not trying to be critical. I'm not talking about, you know, just a little victory here, a little victory there, that most of it was operated from a defensive position. And, oh, I made it through that battle. We're talking about an offensive authority on your life, that you walk into every place and you know how to take control of the spiritual atmosphere and remove and dislodge the enemy. Hallelujah. Somebody say this. Devil. This place ain't big enough for the two of us. And somebody's going to move. And it ain't me. Oh, come on. Give God a shout of praise. Mark chapter 10. Oh, Lord, help me. I'm about 40 minutes behind already. Mark chapter 10. Somebody say, I'm going to move to a new level of spiritual warfare prayer. Mark chapter 10, I'm sorry, verse 13. Mark 10, verse 13. Then they brought little children to him that he might touch them. But the disciples rebuked those who brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was greatly displeased and said to them, let the little children come to me, and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God. Assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter in. That word received there is not the same word that is used when the Bible says, if you believe, you receive. That's lambano or lambano. That means to take it by force. That's not this word. This word means to believe or to accept as true. Whoever does not accept as true the kingdom of God as a little child. Whoever does not just come to the principles of the kingdom and say, oh, that's true, shall not enter in to the kingdom's influence and power and authority. So we got to go to the Word and look at these words and just say, that's true. He said, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. That's true. Come on. He said, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but are mighty through God. That's true. Come on. Amen. He said, everywhere I step my foot, that land belongs to me. That's true. He said, behold, I give unto thee power over all the power of the enemy. That's true. He says, I'm more than a conqueror. That's true. He says, I'm an overcomer in Christ Jesus. That's true. Come on, amen. He says, he gives his angels charge over me. That's true. He says, his glory shall be my rear guard. That's true. Ephesians 6:12 again. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual. Everybody say spiritual. Say those middle three words. Say it again. Say it again. That's where our battle is. Man lives in two worlds. He lives in a natural world. He lives in a spirit world. Now I know that those of you that are here tonight, those of you that come to the Upper Room Church, I know that you look at that and say, well, of course, Brother Steve, I know that to be true. But do we know it to be true? Because most of us spend the majority of our time fighting in the natural. Fighting with people. Fighting with circumstances. fighting with things. I could just get my finances fixed. If I could just get a different boss. If I can just have a nicer wife. Huh? If there weren't just so many hypocrites in the church. Keep fighting in the natural. But if we're going to go into a new level of spiritual warfare prayer, we're going to have to get a breakthrough of understanding. Put this very deep in your spirit. Everything, and I mean everything. Everything that happens in the natural begins in the spirit. I've got to stay right here. In the beginning, God created everything that is created in the natural began in the spirit realm. God is a spirit. Angels are spirits. Heaven is a spiritual place. Come on, y'all hear me? Everything God created, everything you see, the natural, we perceive the natural world through our five senses. We see, we hear, we taste, we smell, we touch. Everything we see, everything we hear, everything we taste, everything we smell, everything we touch began in the spirit realm. It all had its root in the spirit realm. Now, everybody say everything that happens in the natural has its root in the spirit realm. Now, if we're going to get a breakthrough here, church, we keep seeing all these manifestations that happen in our lives. My little manifestation tree here. Huh? Right? Right? Come on. We see divorce. We see anger. We see drugs and addictions. Huh? Sexual perversion. Huh? Huh? Poverty. Poverty. Depression. Are y'all with me? Okay? We see all of these things. We can go on for hours listing things that we see in our natural world, things that are wrong, things that don't line up with the kingdom of God. And we keep trying to go after these things. Abortion. Come on. I believe we should have the toughest anti-abortion laws out there. But you can pass all the laws you want. You're not going to stop abortion. Come on, you can march down the street corner with all the placards you want. You can hang out and put tape over your mouth and thank God we're standing up and doing something. And I'm not saying you shouldn't do it, but that's not going to stop abortion. Why? Because abortion's root is not up here in the natural world. The root cause of abortion, it's down here in the spirit realm. Come on, are you with me here, church? And it's time we stop dealing with the fruit. And it's time we lay an axe at the root of the tree. We got to go after the roots. And if we will begin to move into a new dimension of spiritual warfare prayer, the weapons of our warfare, they're not natural. They're not designed to fight the battle up here. Come on. They're uniquely, divinely empowered by God to fight the battle down here. In the spirit. In the spirit. In the spirit. Somebody say in the spirit.
In the spirit.
Say it again. Say in the spirit.
In the spirit.
Say, well, Brother Steele, I know all this stuff. Do you really? Then why is it that every time you have a weird feeling and you start dealing with it in the natural, I feel like we were friends, but I'm kind of feeling a distance in us. And why are you trying to deal with that in the natural? If you're in the spirit, you're going to be unified. No, you didn't hear what I just said. You didn't hear what the Holy Spirit, you know, I don't want you to hear what I have to say, but I do want you to hear the voice that's within the voice. Somebody say, if I'm in the spirit,
I will be unified.
That's why the Bible says unity in the spirit through the bond of peace. Somebody say we got to go to the root. Jesus lived his whole ministry going after the root. Matthew chapter 16. Let me give you a few verses here. I'm going to come in for a landing in a couple of minutes. Is that all right? Now, we may have different times and seasons in this school of ministry. I may just teach for an hour and a half sometimes. It may just break loose into mass deliverance and breakthroughs. We're just going to flow with the leading and direction of the Holy Spirit. In fact, I know all of that's going to happen. Ooh, glory to God. 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 Say, I'm going beyond the natural. I'm going to deal with the roots. Come on, you're not fighting people. Come on, you're not fighting your preacher. Come on, you're not fighting denominations. Come on, come on. Your battle is not with people. Your battle is not with governments. Come on. Your battle is not with denominations. Your battle is not in the natural. Your battle is with spirits. It's with principalities and powers and spiritual wickednesses in heavenly places. And if we'll get the Thor control and get a hold of the weapons that God has for us and you'll learn how to wield them, we will see those roots die, and then the manifestations will fade away. Somebody say in the spirit.
In the spirit.
Say it again, say in the spirit.
In the spirit.
Say it again in the spirit.
In the spirit.
Worship team, come quickly. In the name of Jesus, Shakara Moshande. Shakara Mamamba Shahande. Shakara Mashande. Come on, let me give you those three prophecies again. Shakara Mashande. Say it after me. Say, the Lord will strengthen me to stand in the face of any enemy. Say it, God is going to take me into a new level of spiritual warfare prayer. Say, I am going to see more answers to prayer than at any time in my life. Oh, somebody give God a shout of praise. Shakara Mashande. Shandara Babakande. Lift your hands, stand to your feet, and begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Shaka, I can't go any farther tonight. Shakara Babababababo. Shaka Mashande. Shaka Babababababo. Shaka. Come on, pray in the Holy Ghost. We're going to get a breakthrough from our environment. We're going to get a breakthrough from our environment. From our environment, we're not going to be defeated ever again. We're not going to be intimidated by the enemy. Shakara Mashande. Shakara Mashande. Shandara Makaka Mandande. Placed you to work with those special needs children. It's not going to be a big outward thing, but you're going to speak the word of deliverance. Many of those children are special needs because they've been tormented by demon spirits. They've been molested, and those spirits have come upon them. They've been abused, but God is going to use you to speak a word of deliverance, and the strongholds are going to go. They're going to go. They're going to go. surface. Jesus. Come on, come on. Whether you're here tonight, whether you're watching my video on the internet, go deep in the spirit. The spirit of the Lord God is upon you. The spirit of the Lord God is upon you now. Oh my God. Close your eyes. Listen. Thus saith the Lord. I will establish my people with wondrous weapons of warfare that will confound the enemy and cause my glory to break forth on the earth. You shall see my power, my authority, and my mighty right hand shatter previously impenetrable arenas. You shall see my mighty angels warring to bring about my purposes. You shall see the enemy flee from before you. And you shall see wondrous manifestations of my delivering power. For you shall not be defeated by the enemy, nor shall you be afraid of him. For you will know that it is I who am fighting the battle. You will see yourself as I have made you, and you shall see the enemy as he really is. I will place my anointing upon you, and you shall be as David before me. You shall not flinch. You shall not fail. For I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I am the God of covenant, and I will do what I have spoken. Fear not. For I am is with you. Oh, somebody give God a shout of praise. Yeah.
And my soul belongs to you, Lord. In a dry air, we
across the aisles, grab the hands of somebody. We're one in the spirit.
Come and take your
in the center of our hearts.
In the center of our hearts. Come and take your place.
Oh, say it again. Declare.
Come and take your place. In the center of our hearts. Come and take. Take your place
in the center,
in the center of our heart.
Come
and take your place.
My soul declares.
And my soul longs for you, Lord, in a
Lord,
the center of our hearts. Come and take your place.
You're the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Oh Lord. Come and take your place in the center of our hearts.
Come
and take your place.
Oh, declare in the Spirit.
Come and take your place in the center of our hearts.
I see that glory again. I see the cloud over top his people again. He's here.
Come and take your place in the center of our hearts.
Come and take. Now as they're singing, pray one for another.
Come and take.
Shut up! Shaka ba 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 ba
How many of you know this is not the work of a man? It's the work of the Holy Spirit. God says, I am going to take you to a new level of spiritual warfare prayer. You're not going to flinch. You're not going to fail. And thus saith the Lord, you're never going to be defeated by the enemy. Every Tuesday night, for the next at least 2 months, maybe much longer, please, although watching online, the DVDs are okay, there's something about being in the atmosphere. How many know it's hard to capture this on tape? Brother Frank, Clark, your prayer life is never going to be the same again. You can feel it, can't you? Shh. Every Tuesday, we're going to be going deeper. If I was you, I'd get on the phone with some prayer warrior friends. I get on the phone with some defeated people and say, you have to be in this school. This is not a church service. It's a school of the Holy Spirit. Lift your hands before you go and say, God, you are taking me to a new level. Spiritual warfare prayer. And I am going to experience more answers to prayer than at any time in my life. Come on, give the Lord a wonderful hand of praise. This weekend's going to be powerful. Listen, we're continuing Sunday night Holy Ghost revival services. But I tell you, I think they're going to go to a whole nother level after this kind of intercession. Come on, amen. Sunday morning, this weekend, I'm beginning a new series, Psalm 23 Revealed. I promise you, you never heard anybody preach Psalm 23 like this. You say, how do you know? Because I never heard anybody preach Psalm 23 like this. God is going to unveil it. It's a lot more potent than you think. Love on one another. God bless you. Walk in the victory of God. Good night.